booze is a feminist issue. The first time I encountered anti-alcohol sentiments from the sisters was as a teenage activist during one of my first proper meetings. A discussion was taking place about holding a conference on male violence towards women, and somebody asked what we would do afterwards. Would there be a party, and how would we pay for the food and drink? One of the sisters sitting cross-legged, sporting a "Mute is Murder" t-shirt, said, "Alcohol should play no part in an event on male violence," before going into some detail about the links between domestic violence and booze. Quick as a flash, a woman who from that moment became a close friend piped up, "But women were the first brewers, we would be denying our foremothers. Pregnant women don't need a blanket ban on drinking. They need the facts." Jenny Bristow read more reading Rachel McCormick's new book on whiskey, Chasing the Dram, makes me recall all the negatives about women and booze that drip feed into our daily life. As I have often observed, alcohol is the new short skirt in that the booze consumed by females is blamed far more readily than a rapist when a sexual assault occurs, and women are warned not to drink when pregnant, taking a taxi, or, as some medics argue, hardly at all. Chasing the Dram reads like the telling of a love affair in all its glory. The intoxicating feeling that comes with the initial discovery, the good times, the laughter, and the highs, the hellish fallout when things go wrong, and the conflict when friends don't share your passion. I love scotch, whiskey, and in particular the delicious, grown-up cocktails such as John Collins and Manhattan. I drank these cocktails with McCormick during a trip to Scotland when we met senior women in the whiskey world, saw how it was made, and met the women who spend their life extolling the virtues of this iconic spirit. Women are blamed for anything bad that happens if we have had so much as one egg cup of wine. Furthermore, our drinking is constantly policed by men. I once went to a restaurant alone while working in Rome and asked for a bottle of white wine to accompany my meal. I had planned on eating three courses and taking my time, having nothing else to do that evening.